And we're back. All right. Did some shopping, and we actually just had a little refresh with some nice Tony Paco's pickles. Mmm. I gotta say, I used to not like pickles until I had Tony Paco's pickles. So, Tony Paco's, if you want to sponsor us in the I assume, 8 views this video will get. I mean, come
totally
find us.
Worth it.
Come find us. We'll sponsor your pickles. And I had a Moad.
You said
as
go
well
to the inn?
Yeah.
Aha! And now you find us.
And you should be in one of the empty rooms. Or not empty, but...
I see no Samus.
Maybe it's in the castle.
Maybe that was Samus. A very obvious toad. Alright, and you find us. We just did some shopping. Peach finally has a parasol. Is that fake Peach?
Grandma!
No, that's right, you're Toadstool.
Grandma, thanks for putting up with all my selfish demands.
Ah! Oh, that's a toad. I thought that was her face. Oh my god, I was terrified.
She's part spider.
Yes.
Don't worry, princess. Little adventure with you. You're going to see the world, make friends, get nailed by all sorts of Italian plumbers, help destroy Smither.
Like tentacle monsters. Mara's beside me. Everything's going to be all right, so don't worry, okay?
Click.
You take care, Grandma. You hear?
Oh, as long as I'm surrounded by all these tentacles.
Tentacles keep me safe.
You didn't fall far from the tree, Peach.
Ah, damn!
Samus!
Zip. I'm resting up from Mother Brain.
Apparently, you can also jump on the bed.
More
Don't
ball.
Worry, she has abs of steel.
I want to see a mock ball. I want to see mock ball.
Missiles. You know, I never really played any of the Metroid games. Though I enjoy the format.
Platformer.
Well, yeah, it's a platformer, but it's one of those...
Metroidvania.
Right, exactly, where you have a big old map, and the idea is you have to explore the map by finding different things that give you access to new areas and stuff. And so you're often going... Yeah, you get the idea. Yeah, so Metroidvania.
So you're often exploring.
Yeah, basically you're just exploring. But it's more like, it's not the standard, okay, we're doing this level, we run through this level, this platformer level, okay, we beat the level, now there's a new level, and maybe there's a different motif to the level or something. No, it's all just one big map. And occasionally you end up in a boss room and have to kill a boss or something. Mm-hmm. Now, there was a, for the Game Boy, a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game.
Mario, knowing you, must have been.
It started off.
Freeze knocking down Yurid, eh? By the way, my pirates say they saw a huge axe flying across the sky. It's probably one of Smithy's nasty friends. Go get him, pal.
Man, I hate guys that just do nothing but spray themselves with axe body spray.
My gills are
Must
failing
be what this
me.
Guy is.
So I'm heading back down. Drop in whenever you have time, okay? Your true mate. Jonathan Johnny Joe.
Aww.
He's a JJJ.
Of course. J. Jonah Johnny Jameson. All right. What was I saying? Yes, there was a Turtles game for the Game Boy. And you started off, the other Turtles, you only started off with one Turtle. I forget who it was. But you have to go through... All the other turtles have been kidnapped, and you have to go through a Metroidvania-type place, rescue the turtles, and each of the turtles has a different ability that allows them to access or do something that gets you through different parts of the level. Huh. Right? Like, Raphael could, drill downwards. Stuff like that, you know?
Or maybe it sounds like the regular NES game that they had for it.
Well, no, that was another, another thing with what was like more like a level. Level by level by level. And yeah, it's not that any of the and all of the turtles are relatively interchangeable outside of the weapon attacks in the original NES game. Which, that's a hard game. The site of Land's End, town made up of reformed monsters. Oh no. A mouse came by the other day, and I overheard him boasting about how he's gonna rule the world because people will pay so much money for Disney things. I don't know exactly where this town is located, but if you follow the road, you'll get there. Follow the yellow dictode.
I was drawing a blank as to why the next area wasn't unlocking. There we go.
Ah, to Land's End.
Not that I had to talk to that guy again.
All right. What have we here?
A little too far.
Woo! How many times can Mario get yeeted out of this thing?
Or without getting brain damage?
That many times.
Come on.
What are you trying
Plus
to do?
Plus one.
Interesting.
Okay.
Red essence. Tell me, what is red essence?
Essence of red.
Oh. Good. You won't be attacked for 3 turns during battle. Interesting.
Invincibility so just... for 3 moves.
Oh, okay. I just thought it like you smelled bad and nobody wanted anything to do with you. What are you looking up, Chris?
More Samus stuff. It looks like you can also find a doll later on.
A doll or a dog?
Doll. D-O-L-L.
Oh, okay.
Of Samus later on.
Oh my god, this has become Gina's girlfriend since he's a doll?
Probably.
There we go. Spin out the inventory a little.
All right, Chris. Give us a topic of conversation. Why is that the noise we make when we're trying to think of something?
Cultural. Let's see.
True. Because different languages do have different noises that they make when they're doing the stall. But how did that come about?
Who even knows?
Well, fat lot of use you are, Chris.
Remember playing
it's like Don't Stop Talking or Everybody Dies, something like that. The bomb diffuser game.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, I remember playing that game and I'm just like, and I'm trying to look up these puzzles for you. And you're like, it's a word puzzle. I'm like, what's the word? Now, of course, that didn't help me because there are multiple ones with multiple U's, multiple H's, multiple ellipses at the end of it. Tackle! Yeah, just what you wanted. Just when you needed it, right? Nope, Mario and Bowser killed everything.
This is why you go around with the 3 highest attack hitters. Magic is limited.
But I'm here too, Mario. I'm your friend. You wouldn't forget about me.
Woo! Nice! Skidoosh! Skipoosh! Aha! Kero, Kamala! Derp! Yep, 3D platforming. Not as fun as it sounds.
Platforming. I don't like it anyways.
Oh, frog a frog a coin coin. So, we need 50 because we actually checked at the froggy dude. We need 50 to get the fairy ring. A I call it the fairy ring because that's what it's called in the Tails games, but it, where it's half FP costs.
Oh.
That's the two cheaper options, either a double XP ring or a double coin ring.
Which means we actually need 100
coins.
Nice
if you really want to do these things, but since frog coins are limited... Unless you cheat.
I was going to say, yeah, how many frog coins could we actually get?
But we actually need 100 of them. So that we can get the fairy ring and still be rich.
But here's the thing. There are other accessories that are just as good, and... The only two people I'd want to use it on is Gino to have his cost for his high-level spells.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he still has room for one more, I notice. Does he turn into a nuke? Does Gino turn into a nuke?
Gino is all done.
Aww. He has room for one more, though!
I know.
Gino, you are rod from God.
Mario has six.
You're not delivering,
Gino. He only
has five. Bowser's getting one at 18. Do they all learn their last one at level 18?
Gino lot.
Not
learned
Gino,
his
apparently.
17.
Oh, Jesus.
Mallow is done with all his.
Oh, well, he's got six, though.
He's got Star Rain.
Star Rain. Yeah, I'm really
Peach
good,
still
guys.
Still has one more for herself.
Remember me? I'm Mallow. I'm really good to have at the party.
Single target heal.
Group hug. Slip time.
Attack. Rez. And a silence.
Oh, wow.
She's insanely cheap as it is anyway.
Yeah, you're right. They are pretty cheap.
I'd probably, if I got one of those rings, give it to Gino. If I did.
And
make my heals even more cheaper.
There's space for one more character, I note.
Ooh.
We're at max characters. Aww. There are no other characters.
I refuse. Recruit Samus. Mother Brain can wait. We need
someone
with a freaking...
Bowser's a mushroom.
Oh, shit!
He never thought of that plan.
Oh, wait, no. Bowser's a one-up.
Oh, my God, you're right. Eat him.
You can turn into a mushroom. Obviously, the,
do
Mar-
it, Mario.
The Mario would
eat
love
me.
Him forever.
I want to be inside you.
Scrow, dust. Immune, bitch.
Fortunately, as a mushroom, I cannot do anything with him. But he does heal.
Oh, he's fine.
I hatched. That's what mushrooms do, right?
It was me.
I came out of my mushroom chrysalis.
It was me, Bowser, all along.
Old man Bowser.
Oh, God.
I would have gotten away with it, too.
Oh, God, John.
You damn Mario, your goddamn Yoshi.
Every time you come across a one-up mushroom, it's actually Bowser.
Sneaky secret Bowser. Oh, it's those flowers. We haven't seen those in a long time. Baby?
Hey-o.
Hey, lad, come and me want more froggy coins. Well, that's not ominous. Oh, okay. All those little,
Time to go to the secret route.
Ooh.
Secrets.
Secrets are no fun. Secrets are things like me having a gun. Bang, 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 bang. Yay, Gino.
Bang,
bang, you shot me down.
Jack up.
All right, Chris.
You shot me down.
Something to talk about. It's a topic of conversation you've been itching to talk about.
India just landed a probe on the moon.
Oh, good for India.
They successfully did it.
Wait, they weren't like the Russians and crashed theirs into the moon?
They were with their first time. But
I mean, the moon's been there taunting us this whole time. Why not launch things at it?
But, yes.
Shoot the moon! Let's
play
hearts.
India is officially the fourth country on Earth to... successfully soft land a probe on the moon.
Now, the U.S. is one. I imagine Russia is the second.
Uh-huh.
Who was third?
probably Japan, I'm guessing.
Richard Branson?
England?
Richard Branson?
Third country was Elon Musk.
Jeremy Clarkson?
No, it was the guy behind Moonraker.
Speaking of Elon Musk, did you hear that...
He's a dick? Yes.
Did you hear
How
that...
How big a dick?
SpaceX. Their starship is now doing hot staging.
Oh, wow.
Which, do you have any idea what that is?
I think that's when, you know, we have this, when you, you break off the initial, the big jet things so that you can send your shuttle further into space, right?
That's staging.
Right. So it's hot staging.
Hot staging is when you ignite the engines before you break it off.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's not unheard of in rocketry.
Yeah. But doesn't sound like it's all that bad.
It's very difficult to do. Difficult to get right. It wasn't doing that previously, and it is now. And it's a little concerning, considering that they eventually wanted to be able to take, like, dozens of passengers.
Why is that concerning?
Because hot staging is a little more dangerous.
Well, then what's the benefits of getting of hot staging?
It's more efficient, fuel-wise.
I guess I can see that. You don't need to get as far with your initial stage, I suppose, if you can hot stage and be accelerating from...
Well, the faster your ship is moving when you fire the engines, the more efficient it is.
Yeah, that's right.
So if you shut off the engines, separate the stages, and then fire the engines,
you've lost a lot
drag,
of momentum.
Yeah,
likely,
drag
right.
is going to slow you down a lot in the meantime.
There are a lot of creepy enemies in Mario. You ever notice?
Well, I mean, there's only so many shapes I can give an enemy.
He's an Italian that went down a pipe and ate a bunch of mushrooms. Who the fuck knows what he's looking at?
I mean, fair's fair. The whole thing does seem like a bad mushroom trip.
Not like a brother. He's like 2 foot taller. What do you want from me, guy?
Now here's a question. If, say, a game came out, assuming that we had never had any Mario games, if a game came out with Mario's motif and style and, you know, characters and things like that, would it do well?
Probably not.
That it came out at the same time, or are we talking about years
You mean
later?
Like now?
Comes out now.
Probably now? Not.
Probably not.
So, in effect... Are we only buying Mario games for nostalgia?
The brand. And nostalgia, yeah. Mario is, the brand is doing a lot of the work for him.
Given if you didn't have Mario come out back then, how many games would we not have? A handful. I think more than a handful.
I mean, Mario was, for a lot of people, the first really big game. The first game that truly hit it big.
For a lot of people,
there were a lot of good Atari
are,
games out here, but...
Really a lot of people that are 30-plus.
Big platformer. Really drive that style of gaming.
Now, I dare say that if we did the same test with Sonic, I think Sonic would do better.
Rick-a-jam.
All the way back in the pipe bowl.
Oh my god, you're right!
It was the chest that we could never get until now.
Well, that's an itch that I didn't know was there. I'd forgotten was there.
Oh, but finally, it's done.
This is a two-part.
My life is just that little more complete.
And on that bombshell, we could end this episode. All right, how we doing? Anything?
And unfortunately, James Renner could not join us this week.
Yeah, not James Renner. But we got Jeremy Renner. Isn't that right, Jeremy? Jeremy says hi.
No, he totally did.
He's totally here. We're high-fiving. There we are. Yeah, yes, I agree, Jeremy Renner. Sonic is a much better franchise than Mario. Thank you, Jeremy Renner. And on that bombshell, we'll end this episode.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.